final nerd news story of the week. It was a big week. Great. So much stuff dropped this week.
So much.
Well, one of the most crazy, awesome, dope things that dropped this week from the people over at Disney Plus was The Mandalorian.
Yay.
They tweeted that we got a release date for Mandalorian season 2. At the time of this taping, we have not seen the trailer yet, but again, that might change. We got a little bit of new imagery in the form of a logo. So previously announced, I mean, we all knew, based on what they announced, is that Mandalorian is coming out October 2020. The second season is set to arrive in that time period, just as promised. Yeah. October 30th. Release date.
So excited. Halloween, let's go.
Couldn't have pushed it any further into October if they tried.
I know, right?
Right, like just right there at the end.
This comes from a tweet from the Mandalorian Twitter page that dropped this week. They said, "This is the day. New episodes start streaming October 30th on Disney Plus. Hashtag The Mandalorian." I want to point out the fact that they said new episodes, plural.
Plural, you're right.
New episodes start streaming on October 30th. No chance they're just going to binge this thing, right?
Yeah, I mean, no. I don't think so. Nah. I mean, considering what they did with the first season, you know?
Right. What did they do with the first season?
They dropped like the first two episodes, I think, but they were like 20 minutes long. They were super short.
Right, we thought we were going to get way more, and we were all waiting on... It was Sunday, right? It was a Sunday.
Yeah, I thought it was going to be an hour-long show, and then it wound up being a 30-minute show.
At least 45 minutes, you know? Yeah. It's like replacing my Game of Thrones binge. Right? I need that hour of Star Wars. I have nothing now. There's a void. We need it. Clone Wars is over. We needed this.
So we'll probably get at least two episodes, you think?
I'm thinking.
On October 30th?
We did look on IMDb, and they have 4 episodes listed. Not titles of the episodes, but they do say 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4. Why put just 4 up and not like the whole season?
You don't think they'd drop 4 episodes at once, do you?
I think it's lofty, but it's, you never know.
Unless you're going to have a 12-episode season. I mean, Jesus, that's half your season right there in one day.
Hopefully it'll be that way. I feel like Favreau wants to give the Star Wars fans, we've been waiting for so long. I feel like he just is like, fuck it, give him the 4 episodes,
pandemic,
you guys.
Like, everybody's stuck at home.
That's
right.
True.
Maybe he'll be cool, or maybe he'll do like a midweek. I don't know. You never know.
We also got the promo art that was dropped in the Twitter thing. Same font, same thing, but they changed it from tan and yellow to now it's blue.
Yeah.
So it went from kind of hot and deserty to now it's more of a cool feeling. Mm-hmm. Maybe that's something going on. Maybe there's some water planet action. Maybe
I
there's some soft, quieter, more nice planets. Maybe it's more in space. I don't know.
See.
But the most important part is you had Mando in the A on the first promo.
Baby Yoda.
But now you got Mando and Baby Yoda.
The child.
Or so, I'm sorry, the child.
The child's coming back.
Baby Yoda.
Probably in a big way.
Oh, for sure.
I mean, we have to assume. So let's talk a little bit about... back to the trailer. Yeah. I've seen so many rumorings on when they're going to drop the trailer.
Yeah.
It should happen any second now.
No, definitely within the next week.
I think so.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, for sure.
Because they were originally going to drop it a couple weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
And then they officially put out that they're going to drop the trailer.
Right.
Then they yanked that. Then Star Wars Celebration was supposed to happen 2 weeks ago. Mm-hmm. I think it was like mid-August in Anaheim. That's probably where they were planning on dropping it.
Probably.
Right. Star Wars Celebration? Because we were all at the Star Wars Celebration. Mandalorian.
That was the one time.
We were all at Star Wars Celebration. Me and Shauna went to the Mandalorian panel, and that's when they dropped the promo for the first season.
Yeah.
And like some footage.
So that was probably their plan, was to drop it at Star Wars Celebration.
Totally.
So it's going to drop any second.
Absolutely.
Let's talk a little bit about plot points and what are you guys most excited about for season 2? I'm just going to throw a couple out here. Obviously, we know there's a potential for Boba Fett coming out.
Right.
We know Ahsoka Tana is going to be on the show. We know, obviously, Grand Moff Gideon busted out that Darksaber. Are we going to get more of his backstory?
Did.
Are we going to get more of him in season 2? Mando's new armor, you know, he's rocking a jetpack now.
Hell yeah.
He's like fully armored. He's like full on Mandalorian now. And of course, Baby Yoda. I mean, we don't know anything about his backstory. We don't know where he comes from, where he's going, anything about the race.
He's so cute.
What's got you guys most excited about season 2? Sean, I'll let you go first.
I mean, I just want to see more of the story. I want to see more Baby Yoda. I want to see more Mandalorian. I mean, I think it's cool that you've got Boba Fett going to make an appearance. But honestly, like,
potentially,
Boba Fett didn't really have much of a presence in
Star Wars. He got robbed in
Star Wars. So I don't care that much about him as most people do. But yeah, no, I'm totally stoked about
it. What are you most excited about? If you had to pick something, Boba Fett, Ahsoka Tana, Moff Gideon's Darksaber, Mando's new jetpack and armor, and Baby Yoda's back history, which would you most
Baby Yoda's back history.
Yeah.
Yes.
Absolutely. That's, that's just what I want to know. And even more back history of Mando himself. Like, I don't, we still don't know that much about him.
Right.
I'm just focused on those two characters. Mm-hmm. I love them, and I just want to see more of them.
They sold us on them, honestly, this season. Yeah. That first season was just like, I feel like that's what everybody cares about. I mean, there's so many other possibilities, but like Baby Yoda is just, I mean, come on.
What I liked about it was very kind of serial. It was very kind of episodic. Like you could just watch one episode and be done.
True.
Like that prison episode, the prison break episode. Yeah. You could have just watched that one. It had a start and a finish.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Great episode. I'm hoping they do a little bit more of that.
Yeah.
Kyra, what's got you super stoked most about season 2?
Ahsoka.
Yeah? Of course.
Oh my God, you guys. I mean, Clone Wars, hello. I mean, the fact that they're putting her as a real human life character in Mandalorian is just so perfectly executed and timed after Clone Wars just ending.
Yes.
Ahsoka Tano is one of the most beloved characters in the Star Wars universe, and it's like, you wouldn't really know who she is if you didn't watch Clone Wars.
That whole last season of Clone Wars was basically just about her.
Yeah, and
those shitty-ass little clone army fuckers. They suck.
They suck.
But you take them out of last season, and it was the Ahsoka show.
But I think Rosario Dawson is going to kill it.
Yeah.
I feel like Ahsoka Tano is just like such a great character. She was there with Anakin through so much.
Yep.
And she just saw him rise and fall. And I mean,
she fought Darth Maul.
She farted Darth Maul.
She fought. And she kind of befriended him a little bit.
Darth
she understood.
Maul.
Yep. And I think that's why people love Ahsoka, because she doesn't judge you. She's been through hell and back too in Clone Wars. I mean, they totally just ostracized her completely.
They killed her off, didn't they?
Yeah.
And then they brought her back? Or they supposedly killed her?
They just like banished her.
I honestly haven't watched Clone Wars that much.
I'm a bad Clone Wars fan. But she was totally banished. And I mean, obviously Anakin, spoiler, welcomed her right back in because they're so close. But she knew a lot of shit that was going on that takes place during Attack of the Clones and Revenge of the Sith. And the way they lined it up, I mean, I just think it's amazing that she's a great character. Tradition, I think.
You think
I just don't know.
You
what's
think she's going to be a mainstay character in the season, or you think it's going to be a one episode and done? Because I think Boba Fett's probably going to be a one and done.
Boba Fett.
I think
sure.
that's just. He might not even be playing Boba Fett. If you didn't know this, the actor, his name escapes me right now, but he played the original clone. He's the one that they made the clone army out of. He played
with Jango.
Jango Fett.
Yeah.
So he doesn't necessarily have to come back as Boba.
Right.
He could come back as an old clone trooper. Mm-hmm. I think they're going to do one episode about Boba Fett getting out of the Sarlacc pit, and that's all we're going to see. And fans are going to fucking have to change their pants after they see that episode, because they're going to be, holy shit, we finally saw Boba Fett come out of the fucking Sarlacc pit.
People are culty about Boba Fett.
Yeah.
You know?
And then he'll go off in the distance. But I'm hoping that Ahsoka becomes a mainstay character. She's at least there, at least in a couple of episodes. Kind of like a Gina Carano was. She wasn't super important to every episode, but she was still in like four or five different episodes.
I think solely based off the fact of how people are so obsessed with this character. I mean, when we went to Celebration,
I
hadn't
so
watched Clone Wars at that point. I knew who she was, but I didn't know how loved she was by all of these people. Like even little kids, little younglings dressed up as her. You know what I'm saying? And I'm just like, I think that alone will make her be in more than one episode, and rightfully so, because she's such a badass character. And Rosario Dawson,
and it's Rosario Dawson
again. That's what
I was
totally
gonna kill it. She's always been a badass woman.
You don't hire
a movie
somebody
star.
Like Rosario Dawson and put him in one episode.
The fans don't want that. I hope she'll be in more than one episode. I think Boba Fett has the potential to have his own side along episodes and something further in the future, because people are so culty about Boba.
Yeah,
and I think he honestly deserves a couple, you know, whatever they'll do.
Nods.
Will they? I don't know. But I mean, I feel like he deserves his own storyline and him just being with Mandalorian.
He can still, I think this might be an introduction of the character so that they can reintroduce him in the Obi-Wan series.
There you go. Now,
so they're just going to give you a taste. All right.
There it is.
So they're just going to give you a taste of Boba Fett in this episode, in this show. And then based on his, you know, the excitement level for it, they'll bring him back for Obi-Wan.
Oh, Obi-Wan. That's right.
Chuck, about you, Chuck?
I'm just, because you guys named everything, so I'm just going to say I'm really excited about Moff Gideon. I think we didn't get nearly as much, what's his name, Giancarlo Esposito as I wanted to get.
Mm-hmm.
So, and obviously, the way they ended it with that cliffhanger, I want to see like where he got the darksaber.
Mm-hmm.
What is he going to do with it? Are we actually going to see some lightsaber dueling?
Totally.
I doubt we'll see lightsaber dueling, but you never know.
Maybe
I mean, Jesus Christ. I just want to see more of him.
So much.
Jesus Christ.
So anyway, yeah, I'm excited to see more of him. Yeah. And obviously, I mean, it's, God, give me 24 episodes, man.
I know. Please, we deserve it after going through this year of COVID. Come on. We need at least 18. I'm calling 18.
That
Favreau,
awesome.
You need to give us 18.
We'll be lucky to get 10.
I think 10 is fair.
10
I think
is 10 absolutely can, fair.
Especially if they're going to be kind of short and they're breaking it up. You know, you never know how they're going to break them up. And just
it might, like Shauna said, they might drop all four and then take a long break.
Like a
and
season,
then,
yeah.
And then
mid-season.
Give us like nine more?
That would be awesome.
Oh,
I'm down for that.
Please, please.
Well, anyway, guys, we could talk about this shit all day. This has been the longest episode of Chuck Little Comics we have done in a long time. Oh, I love it. I love it. I love having three people on the show. It's fantastic. Kyra, can't thank you enough for coming here, man.
I'd love to be here, you guys.
Thank you for the Dune info.
Oh, I know, right?
Dune. Anytime you want me to talk about Dune, you guys know.
Cool.
I am down.
All right, guys. Thanks a lot for watching Chuck Little Comics. We will be here next Sunday right here on YouTube for a breakdown of all the nerdy crap that went down over the past 7 days. We are here to deliver you the dirt in the geekiest way possible, guys. So thanks a lot. Click the subscribe button. Join us here next Sunday and have a fantastic week. Everybody say goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, guys.
Goodbye. Have a fantastic week.